Hello friends, my name is Ruthin VS. You're watching me on TechMaras YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to do a video that is asked a lot by viewers of my channel, which is the best laptop under 15,000 rupees. If you're planning to buy a laptop in the near future, do not miss this video because I've got some awesome laptop in today's list. For all the laptops mentioned in today's list, I'll be mentioning who it is actually meant for, like casual user, medium user, intermediate user, heavy user, gamer, etc. And there is one more thing. In today's list, I'll be considering laptops that are priced higher than 50,000 rupees also. The reason is every other day you can see there is a sale going on Amazon, Flipkart, etc. And you'll get easily 5% off, 10% off from bank offers like credit card, debit card. So you'll get close to 50,000 rupees on these laptops. And I'm willing to bet that some people are ready to put extra 2,000 or 3,000 rupees for a laptop because they'll be getting more value for money if you put that 1,000 or 2,000 rupees extra on these laptops. So I'm considering that people also in this list. So let's start with our list. At number 5 spot, we have ASUS VivoBook 14. The highlight of ASUS VivoBook 14 is it comes at 46,000 rupees 990 and there is a 14-inch Full HD display. It is powered by Core i5 8th Gen 8265U variant. It is supported by 8GB of DDR4 RAM. It comes with blazing fast 512GB SSD. The graphics card is integrated and there is a 2-cell battery which will give you around 3 hours of battery backup. The laptop is very light with 1.5 kg, so it will be portable. There is another version with dedicated graphics card. It is priced at ₹51,990 and the graphics card is 2GB of NVIDIA GeForce MX230. Even with dedicated graphics card, the graphic performance of this laptop is average. So don't choose this for heavy gaming. For light gaming or browsing, Excel, Word, etc., you can go for this. In the connectivity front, you have a charging port, dedicated HDMI port, USB 3.1 Type-C, audio 3.5mm jack, card reader, USB 2.0, and there is a lock port. So what is the pros and cons of this laptop? It has a super fast SSD storage, which means boot and reboot time and app load time is going to be fast. The laptop is lightweight, which means portable, and it has very good keyboard, so the typing experience is going to be good. What are the cons? The graphical performance is not so good, display angles of this laptop is not so good, and the sound is also not good. Who it is meant for? It is meant for casual users and intermediate users. The major disappointment of ASUS VivoBook 14 series is its display is not so good. There is one other laptop that is in ASUS VivoBook S series that is coming with IPS LCD display, which means the display performance is going to be very good. And with all the other specifications that are good about ASUS VivoBook 14 series, this laptop is going to be interesting. The specifications are almost similar, except for the price, which is ₹52,490. And the processor is same. And the display, as I mentioned, is IPS LCD display of 14-inch. The storage is a bit different. You get 256GB of SSD and 1TB of HDD. The operating system will be on SSD, so you can expect fast booting time and application loading time on this laptop. There's a slight bump in the specification of the battery. This one comes with a 3-cell battery, so you can expect up to 5 hours of battery backup on normal usage. Just like other ASUS VivoBooks we have discussed, this laptop also is not meant for gamers. If you are a casual user who likes to browse internet and watch movies and so on, you can choose this laptop. The connectivity in ASUS VivoBook is a bit different from ASUS VivoBook 14 series. It comes with two USB 2.0 card reader, an audio jack, Type-C port, HDMI port, and USB 3.1 port, and a charging port. The next laptop in our series is ASUS TUF Gaming Laptop FX570. So what are the highlights of ASUS TUF laptop? It is priced at ₹47,990 at the moment and the screen is 15.6 inch Full HD. It is powered by Core i5 8th Gen 8250U version. It have 8GB of DDR4 RAM, 1TB of SSHD storage, which means it is faster than normal HDD, but it is slower than SSD. It have a 4GB of NVIDIA GTX 1050 and it have a 3-cell battery which will give you around 3 hours of battery backup. It is weighing at 1.96 kg. It is not so portable but not heavy also. In the connectivity front, ASUS TUF sports a card reader, a Type-C port, HDMI dedicated port, USB 3.1, an RJ45 port, a charging port. There is a lock port, two USB 2.0 port and an audio jack. So what are the pros and cons? As I've already mentioned, SSHD is faster than HDD, so which is a good thing. It is light compared to the gaming laptop segment, so you can say it is portable. And it have very good GPU, the battery is not so good, sound also. So it is meant for. It is meant for intermediate gamers and above average users. The next laptop in our list is Acer Nitro 5. There is two variants available for this laptop, one with AMD processor, AMD Ryzen 5, and other one is with Intel processor, Intel Core i5 8th Gen. So let's look at both of these laptops because both are value for money. Since both the laptops have similar specs, we are looking at it at the same time. One is priced at $46,990 for the AMD variant and other is $52,990 for the Intel variant. Both are having 15.6 inch Full HD display. The AMD processor is Ryzen 5 Quad Core 2500U. The Intel processor is i5 8th Gen 8250U. One is having 8GB of DDR4 RAM and other one is having 8GB of DDR4 RAM with 16GB of Optane drive. Both are having 1TB of hard disk and AMD processor is having AMD Radeon RX 560 processor. And in Intel we have 4GB of NVIDIA GTX 1050 Ti which is a beast of a GPU. And in the both the laptops we have 4-cell battery which will give you around 5 hours of usage. And both the laptops weigh at 2.7 kilograms. So you can say it is not portable. In the connectivity front, both of the laptops are having same ports with audio jack of 3.5 mm, two of the USB 2.0 ports and one charging port. There's a lock port, an RJ45 cable port, USB Type-C, a dedicated HDMI port, USB 3.1 port, a dedicated card reader also. Almost all the pros and cons we have covered while we are giving the specification. There is one thing to add which is a very good design for this laptop. And one more thing I have to specify is the Optane drive. In Intel Core i5 8th Gen variant, they have an Optane drive which will make the boot loading time and app loading time faster for this laptop. And who it is meant for? It is meant for intermediate or heavy gamers and heavy users. The top position in our list is MSI LG 63 gaming laptop. Let's look at the specifications. MSI GL63 gaming laptop is priced a bit higher at 54,990 rupees and the screen is 15.6 inch Full HD display. It is powered by Core i5 9th Gen 9300H variant. This H variant means it is a high performing variant and compared to U variants which is present in all other laptops, this will be performing very well. And there is 8GB of DDR4 RAM and 512GB of SSD, which means booting time, app loading time will be fast because of this SSD. And the graphics in this computer is 4GB of NVIDIA GTX 1050. The battery is a 6-cell battery, so you'll get easily 5 hours in medium usage. It is weighing at 2.2 kg, which means it is not heavy, but it is not portable also. In the connectivity front, we have an RJ45 LAN cable port, a dedicated HDMI port, and there is 3 USB 3.1 port, 1 USB Type-C, 2 audio jack of 3.5 mm, and there is a dedicated card reader and charging port. Most of the pros and cons we have given already while we are covering the specification part. There is two things I have to mention. It has got very good design and the sound quality of this laptop is good and very loud also. But one thing that is downfall of this laptop in this price segment comparison is the price. It is priced a bit higher compared to all other laptops. But with the specification it is giving, I'll say it is reasonable. And who it is meant for? It is meant for intermediate and heavy gamers and heavy users. This concludes today's video. I hope this was informative. And that's it, friends. Thanks for watching. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because there is a lot of effort goes behind creating these videos, and the content creator, that is me, will be happy if you subscribe. So if you subscribe, don't forget to click on that bell icon also, because you will be notified about the latest tech videos whenever I upload. Goodbye. See you on the next video.